Hello again, everyone. Edwin Lernard back once again. In this YouTube NFL prediction segment, I'm going to be giving you my picks and analysis for Week 7 of the 2015 NFL season. The first game, I'm going to take the Seattle Seahawks on the road to defeat the San Francisco 49ers. I know Seattle has not looked as sharp this season. The team has actually allowed 26 sacks, which I believe is a league high, and they've been during the game last week had stated that Seattle was outscored like 69-27 in the fourth quarter with 2 minutes and change left in the fourth quarter last week. San Francisco, though, is starting to show signs of playing cohesively on offense, but they're only averaging 16.7 points per game. They're still, I believe, number 32 in the league in scoring. I'm not quite sold that San Francisco is right back, and I think Seattle... I don't see them losing again this week to the 49ers, and the Seattle defense will show up, and I like them in this game. Now, the next game. Yes, Gio, I did remember that this is in London, and Jacksonville, I believe, is technically the home team. However, you got to go with the better team in this case, Buffalo. They've rotated wins and losses all season, so I believe they're due to win this game. Jacksonville has only one interception this season, and Jacksonville is going to be Jacksonville. I don't see them. I see the very hard press for them to defeat Buffalo. I'll see the look for Buffalo's pass rush to be very dominant and be very strong and formidable in this game, and I believe it will make the difference. So I'm going to take the Buffalo Bills to win this one, though technically a road game. Now, I'm going to take the Washington Redskins at home over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now, Washington right now, the status of wide receiver DeSean Jackson is uncertain. However, the team has only allowed 7 sacks. They give their quarterback a lot of protection. I think that could be a big difference in this game. Tampa Bay going in there, I don't see the rookie quarterback being able to go into Washington. Washington is not that good, I understand that. But to go on the road, defeat the Washington Redskins. The Redskins are not really, I mean, these two teams by record are not very good. But Washington, I think, is playing probably a little bit better over the last few weeks overall, and they are at home. Washington is 2-1 at home this season, so I do like the Redskins. Now, Tennessee, I'm going to take Atlanta on the road to defeat the Tennessee Titans. Tennessee had an abhorrent performance last week. They haven't won a home game since October of 2014. At least before that game, they had the number one pass defense. But Atlanta, I think last week was an aberration. I think when you got the combination of Matt Ryan and Julio Jones, that is a very explosive combo. And I do see Atlanta has the number one run defense as well as far as average yards given up per game on the ground. And I think that will play an integral role in the outcome of this game. And I do like the Atlanta Falcons to win on the road. Now, the next game, I'm going to take the Indianapolis Colts to win at home against the New Orleans Saints. Now, Indy is very interesting. They're 0-3 against teams that are... 500 or better, and then they're 3-0 versus teams with a losing record. New Orleans does have a losing record. The Saints are also 0-3 on the road this season, number 32 in total defense. The defense has been a deplorable, to say the least. When you have quarterback Drew Brees on your side, you do have a chance in any game, but it's not going to be enough, and I do like the Colts in luck to win this one. Now, the next game, I'm going to take the Detroit Lions to win at home over the Minnesota Vikings. Detroit has -8 turnover differential, which is the worst in the league. They could just keep the turnovers down. Minnesota is number 2, surprisingly, almost surreptitiously, has the number 2 scoring defense in the league, 16.6 points per game allowed, and they're number 8 in total defense. So their tenacious defense has made Minnesota competitive. However, They're a different team on home as opposed to on the road, and they are going to be on the road in this game. And I do like Detroit to win this game At least I'd say maybe by a touchdown, it'll be fairly competitive divisional game, but I like Detroit to win. Now the next game, I'm going to take the Pittsburgh Steelers on the road to defeat the Kansas City Chiefs. Now, if I was skeptical and cynical about Pittsburgh before, I sure not anymore. I'm very much a believer in them, no matter who's quarterbacking. It seems like they took it to Arizona last week. They've won two out of three, and in that span, they've surrendered about 19 points per game in that period. Kansas City is going to be without running back Jamaal Charles. Kansas City's points in each game has diminished over the last four games, so that's not a very good sign. And I see this team. Kansas City's in trouble. This was a team that many thought would challenge the Denver Broncos this season, and it looks like it's not going to happen. I'm going to take Pittsburgh on the road. The next game, I'm going to take the St. Louis Rams at home to defeat the Cleveland Browns. The St. Louis Rams, their offense is putrid. They're number 31 in scoring offense in the league. The pass rush is very good. They have 19 sacks, so that's going to be the determine, I think, help determine the outcome of this game. Cleveland quarterback. That team has allowed, I believe, at least four sacks, at least in four consecutive games. So they're going to have to give their quarterback a little better protection. The tight end, Gary Barnage, has five touchdowns. He's been a surprise this season. He's played very well. And Cleveland is really playing very competitively. They did everything but beat the Broncos last week. So I expect this to be a close game, but St. Louis emerging victorious at home. Now the next game, I'm going to take the Miami Dolphins to win at home over the Houston Texans. Miami accumulated 434 yards in total offense. I believe they scored 38 points in the coach's debut. They're showing cohesiveness on offense. The team looks like they're rejuvenated under this new guy. And Houston, they have some, I mean, their Houston has not played well. But they do have the guy at number one in receiving yards, DeAndre Hopkins. And when you have J.J. Watt, you do always have a chance to win, I believe. But they are on the road, and Miami looks like they're starting to turn things around, so I like them to win at home. Now, New England, there's not enough superlatives to really say about them. I do like them at home to defeat my Jets. It'd be interesting. You got the number one scoring offense in the league versus the number one scoring defense in the league. The Patriots have averaged nearly 37 points per game, and their defense is somewhat unheralded. Their defense, they've tied for third in sacks in the league with 19. The New York Jets, they have a very lethal combination with Brandon Marshall and Chris Ivory, and they also play very good defense. And I think in this game, considering it's a divisional game, and the Jets do play the Patriots, even in seasons when the Jets really were not that good, the number of games they've been competitive with the Patriots. And I see this game being close, and this is an improved Jets team. However, it looks like New England's on their mission this season, and I don't think the Jets might beat them at New Jersey later this season, but I don't see them getting them at New England. I like the Patriots at home to win this one. Now, the next game, I'm going to take the San Diego Chargers at home to defeat the Oakland Raiders. The Oakland Raiders have improved tremendously. I give them a lot of credit. Charles Woodson is one of three players with four interceptions. Their run defense has actually been stupendous. Number four in run defense so far this season. San Diego, Phillip Rivers, he threw like 65 passes last week. I hope he's got enough in the tank to play well this game. I believe he will. And San Diego's also number one in total offense right now. And when I look at the Chargers, they're not nearly as good as they were in years past when they were like these perennial contenders to go to the Super Bowl like 4 or 5 years ago. But they're still good enough to beat the Raiders, and they are at home, and I think that will make a difference. I like San Diego to win. Now, the next game, I'm going to take the Giants to win over the Dallas Cowboys. I don't believe Tony Romo is going to be back in this game. Yes, the Giants were annihilated this past week against the Eagles on the road. I think the Giants have shown are a resilient team, though. They're not going to lose two in a row any more than they can help it. Dallas has lost three straight with Romo out. The team has not looked good. The Giants only scored 7 points against Philadelphia last week. They're obviously going to score more in this game, I believe. And I think even 20 points will be enough to win it. I see the Giants winning at home. Now, Carolina Panthers. If anybody was skeptical or cynical about this team before, they certainly can't be now. This team is definitely legitimate. They are for real, including last week's win over the Seattle Seahawks. Going back to last season in the playoffs, they've won 10 of their last 11. I mean, this team really can be a team that can contend for the Super Bowl, I believe. I don't think it's too early to say that. Luke Kuechly is tremendous, and Cam Newton has showed to be nearly unflappable. He's becoming a very composed, poised quarterback, and you could see his progression and evolution, I think, game to game. Now, Philadelphia, they got their swagger. I know they just beat the Giants, and they're starting to come around. They've been playing better in recent weeks. But this is a Carolina team that is red hot. They are at home, and I think their personnel is better than the Eagles, and I like Carolina to win at home. Now, last but not least, I'm going to take the Arizona Cardinals at home to defeat the Baltimore Ravens. The ravenous defense, no more Baltimore. Really, this was a team I picked to win the division this season. Arizona is number two in scoring offense, nearly 34 points per game. Number one in interceptions. Wide receiver Larry Fitzgerald is number one in receptions with 20 plus yards. So he gets in the open field. Forget it. It could be a very long day for Baltimore. I see Arizona winning this one decisively at home. They lost to Pittsburgh last week. Now they're at home. And they're not gonna be in the best mood. I think it's gonna be taken out on the Baltimore Ravens, and I do like Arizona to prevail at home. Now, anyway, people, that'll conclude this YouTube NFL prediction segment for my Week 7 2015 NFL picks. And until next time, people, Edwin Leonard saying, stay well.